Hey everybody, well if you followed our videos long enough, you know I kind of have a love-hate relationship with Polaris. Because they do some things really, really well, and yet at the same time, they let us down on some things that to me are very important. I preface that to say, I struggle with the fact that I oftentimes say that if I could only have one ATV, and I don't need people to get technical with me on ATV versus UTV, one ATV, it would be a 50-inch racer. I love these things because there is no other machine that's available on the market that you can sit down and carry somebody safer than in an ATV, especially because I carry my special needs daughter oftentimes riding with me, and it's a safer way to explore the trails than on an ATV, in my opinion. But there's nobody else that makes a 50-inch machine like this, and there's no other machine out there that is as agile, as light, as nimble, as responsive, just as good a platform as the RZR. But it struggles in some issues. Now, I've also said that I'm not a fan of CVT transmission. Boy, do I wish somebody would put a centrifugal clutch shifter transmission. Could you imagine a RZR or some UTV with a centrifugal shift transmission? It would be so much fun. And part of the reason I don't like CVT transmissions is the fact that it takes RPMs to get them moving, and then it seems like you've got more RPMs to keep the machine going than it should have. And then, especially in the case of the RZR, absolutely the worst system possible because of the drivetrain and the way the clutch works for slowing down. I mean, every time I get in this, I fall in love and I go up the mountainside and then I head back down. And if you're a RZR person, you know exactly what I'm talking about. You let off of the gas and it clangs and stutters and then starts to slow down a little bit, the wheels skid, and then all of a sudden the RPM drops to a low enough RPM that all of a sudden it starts freewheeling. Horrible. What's the solution? Oh no. If it starts to do that as you're going down a hill and you want to slow down, just give it a little gas. Just doesn't make sense to me. I'm sorry. So that has just been an Achilles heel for me that I just wonder about why. I mean, Suzuki King Quad, a great CVT transmission, engages right away, slows down very good. The new Terex 4, I'm amazed. Again, engages right away when you give it some gas and slows down good with that engine braking. Now, I think part of the problem, too, is a lot of these engineers, with a lot of people, have never driven a manual transmission. And that's what we emulate with engine braking, is when you have a car with a standard transmission, that you shift into different gears, it has a clutch to move those, a dying breed that actually takes a little skill to operate correctly and cleanly. I love standard transmission vehicles. I've got a lot of them. So these people are trying to make the CVT, and they it works like a watercraft. There's no gears to slow you down. So I keep rambling. But a good friend of mine, and I guess I'm going to owe this to him, Gail Ryan from Rifab, the guy that makes these incredibly high-quality folding windshields, the cargo boxes, luggage racks, a lot of stuff for the UTVs, had told me he puts a one-way bearing in his RZR. It makes a big difference. I don't know anything about CVTs. So one day, I'm just going, I'm fed up with this. I took it, for a ride, and I contacted Eric at SLP, Starting Line Products. Now, those guys have spent a lot of time with snowmobiles and more recently UTVs working on clutches. And I asked him about one-way bearing and the new EBS, what that is, the helix in the back that would make that. And he goes, oh, we can put a package together. And I go, can you fix the clutch so it engages better, runs better? And he goes, yes, we can do that too. Because really, he goes, it's a really basic clutch system in here, and it's set up to accelerate fast. because it seems like people want to accelerate fast and that's their measure of performance, not how well it works in between. Boy, I'm game. Let's try it. So they installed a one-way bearing. Now there's two clutches on a CVT. I don't want to get too involved here, but there's two clutches on a CVT transmission, the primary or drive clutch and the secondary or driven clutch. And they're both kind of like a pulley. You know, they have sheaves that go in and out with the belt that sits in them. So now on the drive set, on a Polaris, when it's sitting still, there's no throttle applied, the front primary is apart and the belt is sitting down here just spinning. Well, now the one-way bearing makes it so when you let off of the gas, this belt can only spin, the bearing will only spin one way, which means it can apply braking to the secondary or driven clutch that powers the wheels. Again, let me back up a little bit. The front sheaves on the drive clutch start apart, and as you give it power, they move in, moves the belt up, which changes the gearing. And as it pulls on the back, which starts on the top, it pulls that one, it pulls apart and lets the belt go down and effectively changes the gearing. So as you give it gas, the front starts small, gets bigger, the back starts big, and gets smaller. Think of a 10-speed bicycle, but just with, you know, infinite adjustability in between there. So when you let off of the gas, the front pulls apart. The back is still being powered by the wheels, turning as you're coasting down. But when the front gets all the way out, it just spins. With a one-way bearing, that will hold it in position. So the belt has some grip there, you know, to kind of keep it from spinning as much. On the back, there's a helix, and I'm not going to go into too much of that, simply because I don't understand it real well. But there's an EVS helix that you can put in. So depends on which RZR you have, they can install a one-way bearing in the front. The EBS helix in the back, or if you have a 570 like mine, it has such a cheap piece of junk driven secondary clutch that it's not even adjustable in any way. So you have to just throw it away and get a new modifiable clutch from them. And while they do this, they can get the secondary clutch, the driven clutch, put the EBS helix in it, and then they also do their little bit of magic tuning with different springs and weights to control how these pulleys or sheaves come together and how much power it's going to take. So big explanation, but what happens here is amazing. Because of the way the Polaris clutch is set up and it just spins on this bottom and you have to get some RPMs to pull this together and start working, you can't make it just like I love on the Suzuki King Quad or the T-Rex, but it can come close. You get the RPMs, and what I have found best with these weights is what it does to the cruising speed. Now, all of a sudden, you start getting this thing moving, and you got to get a little RPMs to get it moving, just like always. But then once it gets moving, you can get into this cruise, and it's noticeable how the RPM drops in a cruise, 15 to 30 miles an hour. You can feel that there's a lower RPM. Makes machine quieter, easier to talk side by side. And then all of a sudden, you get to a hill or got to give it some gas, and it hooks up, revs up a little bit, and goes. Really great. But the magic of this, the true magic, is putting this all together. And I just came back. I wanted to show you some video of this, but I just got so excited. I just had to do this right now. I just came from the top of the mountain. I just drove up to 11,000 something and just came down the mountain. And what would have been an absolutely aggravating experience has become an incredible pleasure. This has transformed the CVT in this thing to one of the best I have ever driven. I can now come down off of that mountain and run down and let off of the gas, and this thing just kind of slows down. Not too much to where it wants to throw you forward. I've complained about that on some of the engine braking systems, that they apply too much engine braking and it just doesn't feel right. This is just right. It just starts slowing you down. And the beauty is, you can be going 20 miles an hour downhill, let off the gas, and it'll just slow down, slow down, slow down. And when it comes, and no ratcheting or rattling of the transmission and the drive system, just smooth. And it gets down to where it starts to idle, and guess what? It comes to a stop. There's none of that freewheeling where it runs away. So, incredible. Polaris, I don't know why they don't do this to every one of their razors, but the fact that they didn't is water over the bridge, so they say. But we now have a solution, and it's amazing. I think if you need the whole shebang and send it to them, if I remember correct, it's about $700, but you know, it depends on what razor you have, so I don't want to quote figures, because I needed a whole new rear clutch and a helix and a one-way bearing and had them install it and had the different springs and weights put in. So I needed as much as could be done, including buying the tool from them to remove the primary clutch. So I needed everything. And they turned it around just like that. So, you know, you could get the tool from them. They UPS it to you or buy a tool someplace else. Take that primary clutch off. Send that to them. They'll rebuild it. Put the one-way bearing in it. Send it back to you. If you need a new secondary clutch like I do, then they'll fix that one up, modify it, and send it to you. You can have it in just several days. It's remarkable to me the difference that this has made in this razor. Now all of a sudden, I don't know if I have a love-hate relationship. I might just have a love relationship, because this clutch system that SLP has done for this razor has transformed it into something that every time I go down a hill, or especially those rocky little tiny trails, that I would just curse and wonder, what the heck, I'm going to build my own. To a vehicle that is absolutely amazing. I cannot tell you how this clutch transformed this vehicle. Anyway, so one of these days I'm going to go back out and film it to show you the difference. But if you own if you're in the market for one of these, you know how your razor works. You don't need to see that thing clanging and banging and, you know, on every downhill or freewheeling and running away from you, you know. Well, this one just slows down and stops. So, amazing, amazing transformation. I now am even more in love with my razor than ever before. So, thanks to Gail Ryan for turning me on to the need for a one-way bearing. And thanks to the guys at SLP for setting this thing all up like this. So, you know, contact them. They've got this whole package. They know exactly whether you're working on an 800, a 570, or which model, what year you've got. They know the package, they know exactly what you need, and you can tell them kind of how you want. We've modified the springs and weights on mine because I was not a mudder or a hill climber or a drag racer. I wanted good cruising speed, and they set it up for that, so they can set yours up exactly like this one, and you'll have nobody to blame for its lack of performance or something that doesn't work but me. Or you can tell them, explain what you need, and they can set it up for that. Do it. You're going to love it. Man, I used to say that the first thing you need to do to a vehicle is tires. I'm telling you, if I would have only known, the first thing I'd do to my razor is change this clutch system. Contact SLP and get my clutch system. I cannot tell you enough. So I'll just keep, I could just keep rambling on about this, but I'll move on. And maybe one of these days I'll get some filming. But contact SLP. Either you can give them a call or contact them on email, or just go to their website and check out their products that they have. I can guarantee you won't be disappointed. Hey, I'll see you next time. Till then, God bless.